dear participants, nice to hear your black squares. Let me start with the introduction of our team, of the jury team which works on this series of problems. First, can you tell me if you can hear me? Can somebody tell me if you can hear me?
Yes, we can.
Yeah, very good. All right, I'm trying to find Yan Pan, but maybe he's not present. It's all already late evening in China, I suppose. Okay, myself, I'm Arkady Skopenkov, professor at Moscow Institute of Physics and Technology. In a moment, Eugene Kogan will join us and wave his hands. But now let's start with mathematics. Ah, Jane, please. So here is Eugene Kogan, a student of High School of Economics in Moscow, Faculty of Computer Science.
Hi.
Very good. So let's start with mathematics. I'll share my screen.
We actually start with section two, not section one. That is, we start from Olympic problems, not from motivations. And you shall see that those Olympics problems are actually very easy to solve. Okay. Please let me know if you not see my screen, but hopefully you can. So one of the most elementary problems with which you can start solving this series of problems is the following representation problem. Can the following number be represented as a plus square root of b, where a and b are rationals? And let's consider several cases, several examples. For example, when the number is 3 plus 2 square roots, then of course this square root equals to 1 plus 2. So this can be represented in the required way. The next example is square root of is cubic root of 2. And then the idea of solution is simple. Just write an equation, right? And just take cubes of each side of this. You will very see. But let me now consider. Oh, very good. There is part H, which might not be yet on the internet, but I hope that organizing committee will update internet version, and this part will be present on the internet.
Let me continue for a short period without the file, without sharing the screen. For that number, the idea is to find a cubic equation with rational coefficients, which has this number as a root. And such a cubic equation is easy to find using the triple cosine formula. Probably you don't know this formula, but it's easy to derive it, to deduce it using the cosine of sum. And this is the hint for that problem. So let's go on. I hope that you have problems before your eyes. You have access to the internet. And let the next problem which I want to comment upon is lemma 212. And here I would like to give warning rather than hint. And a warning is that, of course, it's natural to guess that the set of numbers representable in the form a plus square root of b, where a and b are rationals. It is natural to guess that this set is closed under the operations. Sum, difference, multiplication, and division. But mind you, it is not. For example, 1 plus square root of 2 is an element of this set. Square root of 3 is an element of this set, but their sum is not an element of this set. So please, still the idea to invent some set which is closed under those operations is very good, and hopefully you can do that. Next one is, again, a hint. So suppose that you have some polynomial with rational coefficients. For example, a cubic polynomial which you obtain by finding a polynomial whose root is cosine of 2 pi over 9. How to deal with that polynomial? And here, the conjugation lemma is very helpful, and it's lemma 213, part E. And this lemma states that if a polynomial with rational coefficients has a root 1 plus square root of 2, then it has a root 1 minus square root of 2. And of course, you can easily prove this fact. However, after you try by yourself, very good. Yeah, that's the right file. Sorry. After you try to do that, please find out the solution. Please find the solution suggested in this series of problems, because that solution would be easier to realize for a higher degree of equations. Okay. I will only briefly. I will only briefly describe the next subsections of section 2. It's easy. Yeah. I'll now share the screen. Again. So we go to section 2.2, and here we generalize the previous problems to cubic roots. So the characteristic problem, the main problem, is to find out whether the following number can be represented in a more complicated way. A plus B square plus B cubic root of 2 plus C cubic root of 4. With rationals a, b, and c. And again, the first part is the easier, although, of course, it's the easier, but it can't be solved without the conjugation lemma. And the idea is that if a polynomial with rational coefficients has a root like that, it also has some other roots. Namely, the roots described in the conjugation lemma, this one and this one, where epsilon 3 is the third root of unity. And that's where the series of hints to degree 2 conjugation lemma will be useful, because you can prove analogously degree 3 conjugation lemma and so on. So this number square root of 2, it is the root of the polynomial x square minus 3. It is a degree 2 polynomial, so it can have three roots. So you only need to prove that all those three roots, x0, this one, x1, this one, and x2, this one, are pairwise different. And that's really a part of solution which should not be missed. It's non-trivial, and it will lead to some restrictions to further on when we generalize these problems to theorems. Yet another hint for part B of this problem. And here, yeah, the idea is very similar to analogous problems with square irrationality in the denominator. But now, if you have a plus b square root of 2 here, you multiply both parts by a minus b square root of 2. Right. But if you have this more complicated number, then you want to understand what would be the cubic conjugate. So how to multiply both numerator and denominator to obtain a rational number in the denominator. And actually, here a solution can be formalized by algebra. Again, let's consider, it's hard for me to write at this different computer, so let me tell you some simple formulas just by words. Let's consider two polynomials. The first one is x cubed minus 2, right? And its root is the cubic root of 2. And the second polynomial is 1 plus 5x plus x squared. So it's actually what we have in the denominator. And the point is that these two polynomials are relatively prime. For this reason, there are polynomials u and v such that u of x times x cubed minus 2 plus v of x times 1 plus 5x plus x squared equals 1. So this is the usual way of representing greatest common divisor of polynomials. And it is proved analogously to Euclidean algorithm for numbers. And what is important is that it's constructive. You can find both u and v. You can explicitly find both u and v. So that's the hint for this problem B. This is the hint, but not a solution. Very good, let's go on. So with all this theory, you arrive at solutions of all those problems. Yeah, mind you, in each of these subsections, the first problem is most complicated. So please, you should, after maybe trying several minutes to solve this problem, you should go further and try to prove lemmas which are required for these problems. Well, number three, it seems much more complicated because we already have a much more complicated number, right? Like this one, where the coefficients are irrationals. But in fact, it is not more complicated. So passage from 2 to 3 is more complicated than passage from 3 to the general case. So I think I will not comment on this part at all. Let me see, maybe there are some typos, at least in the internet version. Yeah, there is a typo. At the very end of section 2.3. Of course, this sentence is incorrect, but if you just read the previous lemmas, you can see that this becomes correct if you replace this condition by the opposite one. Not a unique real root, but more than one real root. Then neither of these roots is expressible by radicals with only one root extraction. Let's see. And now, in the previous three sections, you actually dealt with expressions which are obtained using summation, multiplication, division, and only one root extraction. But now what to do if there are several root extractions? For example, like that, right? And one of the ideas is to prove analogs of the previous results and lemmas for these more complicated expressions. And in principle, this could be done, but a better way is to split a complicated problem into several simpler problems. For example, here I will write some formula. So let's consider the set Q of square root of 2. Which is defined as the set of numbers A plus B square root of 2. Well, I will not write it, where A and B are rationals. And let's consider a larger set Q of square of the fourth root of 2 which is defined in a similar way, except that here we have the fourth root of 2, and here A and B are not rationals, but are elements of this set. Is it clear enough, or should I explicitly write the definition of this object? Please tell me if I should not. If at least somebody will tell me that it's clear, that then I will not write it. Otherwise, I will. Well, sorry. Thank you, but I warn you that I would not. I can't promise that I can't promise you that I can follow chart. I'm working not on my own computer. There are some technical problems, so they require my attention. So please just tell me explicitly, loudly. Please don't write in chat. If you have some questions, again, please write them immediately so that you can follow the presentation. Okay, I did understand that this part is clear and I will not write it. And the point is that this set is very similar to this set, right? Here A and B are rationals. For this set, A and B are not rationals, but are elements of this field, that is of this set, which is closed under addition, multiplication, division. And so all properties which you proved for this set, some properties which you proved for this set will automatically hold for this set. The proof will be the same. So that's the idea. Use a sequence of such extensions rather than one complicated extension. Okay, I think that's it. Yeah, there is actually one typo in this subsection, but I think you can download the updated PDF file from the internet tomorrow morning, and then it will be fine. So we only have 3 minutes. Maybe I'll take 5 minutes, but let me express why these Olympic problems are interesting. And so for this, let's go to section one. So it's classical thing that some equations can be used by radicals. So here is the definition. A real number is called expressible in real radicals if it can be obtained using number one and operations of addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and taking the nth root. Well, so there is a more mathematical, more formal restatement of this problem. And of course, you know from school that any real root of a quadratic equation with rational coefficients is expressible by real radicals. So this is what the formula for solving quadratic equation tells us. Let me tell you how this generalizes to the equation of degree three, right? How to solve equation of degree three in radicals. And here I will write a simple formula. So I will write a simple formula. A plus B cubed. Equals to, well, that will be, of course, the ordinary formula, but in a slightly different way. And this slight difference is really what allows to solve the cubic equation. It's a cubed plus b cubed plus, and we group the two remaining summons. 3ab multiplied by a plus b. Well, I'm sorry that I'm writing this beautiful formula in such a non-beautiful way. Why it's useful? Because it shows that the number x, which equals to a plus b, is a root of a cubic equation x cubed minus 3abx minus a cubed minus b cubed equals to zero. So if we find some real a and b such that 3ab equals to minus one and a cubed plus b cubed equals to minus one, then we can represent this equation. Yeah, then the number a plus b will be the root of this equation. Well, again, here I will ask, is it clear, because it's really one of the most important points. So we want to find A and B such that this is minus one. And these three AB equals minus one. Then A plus B will be the root of this equation. And then, of course, we can find such A and B using a system of quadratic equations, right? And extraction of root of degree 3 once. So that really shows that this equation has some root expressible by real radicals. And it is not hard to show that this equation has exactly one real root, no more than that. Well, again, I will ask you to tell me if somebody is not sure that he or she will be able to complete this idea to obtain a solution. Oh, sorry. Of course, I prefer interactive discussion, but now the time is over. So let me very shortly tell you hints to other problems. Here we have analogous situation for degree 4. And the idea is to represent any equation of degree 4, or at least any equation with missing x cubed coefficient in the form x cubed plus p. Squared equals to qx plus r squared. So again, well, the first idea is, of course, to write down the coefficients for x squared, for x to the zero in this equation, and in this equation, and arrange p, q, and r so that the coefficients for the same degree will be the same. Well, I will tell you no more about that. So this is how one solves equations of degree 3 and 4. And now an interesting result come. Well, actually two interesting results come. The first one says that even for cubic polynomials, this is not the rule. That is, there exists a cubic polynomial with rational coefficients, known of whose roots is expressible by real radicals. So for some cubic polynomials, it is possible to express their roots, but not for all. And of course, the most interesting and the most famous theorem is Galois theorem, which is a complex analog. I will omit a definition of expressibility by radicals. It's analogous to the real case. But the theorem states that there exists an equation of degree 5 with rational coefficients, known of whose roots is expressible by radicals. And that's the main result of this series of problems. And those simple problems with which we discussed at the beginning of this short lecture, really help you to find a way to this problem, to this Galois theorem. Thank you. Here I stop. I think I will ask for questions. Please ask questions if you have. Well, you will have possibility to ask questions later. So now we shall stop this discussion. Thank you for your attention. And please send us problems as soon as solve at least one of them.